Future Hall of Famer Saul Canelo Alvarez, and our 2022 winner is Derrick James, among the sport's best, whose reputation strengthens in the guidance of undisputed junior middleweight champion Jermell Charlo, as well as Errol Spence Jr., who we can't wait to get into the ring against Terrence Crawford July 29th. And Derrick has been a driving force out in Texas. So congratulations to the 2022 winner, Derrick James.
Hello everyone, very happy to be here. It's very like an amazing honor. I'm always like top, you know, like almost there, not there. Finally made it. Thank you. I want to say I'm very happy to receive the Eddie Futch Trainer of the Year Award from the BWA. And at the same time, I'm very thankful to be in this space and time with so many great people in the sport of boxing. To where it's like to be here, people couldn't imagine. Because even watching before I was even in boxing, watching it, couldn't imagine. Couldn't even think to say, hey, I want to be trainer of the year, I want to do this, whatever. I train world champion. You never really can, you know, just can't imagine what you can do with the skills of the kids that you have around you. I'm very thankful also to share the night with my brother, David Dinkins, to be winning an award also. I'm very thankful for having my wife here, Tish, for supporting very well, having my family in the BBC, and also Showtime. I'm even more thankful for the young kid who followed his older brother to the Boys and Girls Club and started boxing because I wanted to be like my older brother. So I thank that kid for dreaming to be able to become someone who can contribute to other kids and help develop these young men and grow these young men into great fighters. And no one can ever tell you that you can't be who or whatever you want to be. Because I've been told, get out of boxing, you're not this, you're not that. Even still to this day, people still comment and say, listen, Dad, you should do this against Terrence Crawford. You should do that. I'm like, I'm okay, you know, thank you, I appreciate it, I'm okay, you know. And I'm very thankful to my mother, my father, and my grandmother. Everybody in my family has sacrificed to help me develop and become the young man that I am. I'm also thankful for everyone in the Boys and Girls Club that I grew up in, that's where I started boxing. Everybody contributed to me becoming the young man that I am, to kind of help mold me, my boxing coach, to all of the guys. We started boxing at 5 years old, listen. So we were, the team was financially challenged. So we all had to wear the same mouthpiece. So one guy comes out, that's right for me. And so you think about everybody, this guy fights, next week, wash it out. So, you know, and we didn't think it was a big deal, we just wanted to fight. So never knowing that those situations can take you to become in, you know, and to know so many great people, and be in a room with so many great people. And, you know, it's just very, very inspirational. And if you know the thing about this, I wasn't even in boxing. But what happened is, I go to a fight, I see Errol Spence's father. His father asked me, could I help his son? So really it's like, that brought me into boxing. And so, we're still riding along, Errol and I, and we do have a big situation coming up. And there's something everybody's been waiting on, and I am waiting on it also. Tired of talking about it. It's time to get the business going, you know. And so I'm just very fortunate to be able to help Errol, help Jermell, help Frank, help Anthony Joshua now, help Ryan Garcia alone, and to help them become young men that have developed them to the great fighters that I know they'll be. Thank you all. Appreciate that. Good. Thank you.
Imagine you guys are getting a little hungry, so in a few minutes we're going to take a break for dinner. When we return, we'll pay homage to those who we lost in this past year and announce the last 2 years Bernie Award winners for excellence in boxing journalism as well as photography. And I want to remind everyone about the silent auction, where there's a treasure trove of great merchandise. Some of it's been brought up here on the far wall for you to take a look. And a reminder that before you leave, take a goodie bag on the way out. And I know you guys are members of the media, so keep it to one, because I already know how you guys are, and I'm one of you. So enjoy your dinner, and we'll be back to continue with tonight's program.
I'm Ellie Seckback. Ellie Seckback reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com.
I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.